गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन एंड वेलकम बैक टू अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ हॉगवर्ट्स मिस्ट्री एट अ वेरी लेट टाइम. आई द अपडेट डिडंट कम आउट व्हेन आई एक्सपेक्टेड, सो आई बेसिकली जस्ट स्टेड अप फॉर 2 hours वेटिंग फॉर द अपडेट, बट दैट वॉज अ बैड थिंग. इन केस यू गाइज डोंट नो, द रोब्लॉक्स बैटल्स स्टार्टेड टुडे फॉर मी एंड आई वोक अप एट 1:30 AM, सो हाइप्ड. आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू सी दैट फर्स्ट बैटल बिटवीन काइंडली कियन एंड डेनिस. A spoiler, kindly Keen lost, which was a bummer because he was the one I was supporting. But that's all right. That's what the battles are about. I just woke up very hyped for that, and since then I've been waiting. And then I did this. I started the recording when, and then I realized I forgot to do the classes. Okay, I forgot. Then I closed the recording. I did the classes, and now it is time to fetch the Mer Queen's tribute, and it better get us to the world quickly. Now, as I go to the courtyard to meet with my friends, I should let you know that I'm still sick. I still have a cough, so I really should not talk too loudly today. And what I'm saying is that you guys know that last week, right after I was finished recording, I got like extremely sick. I got sick to the point where my parents thought that I got the pandemic thing, but I didn't. It was I'm perfectly fine, but I'm still recovering from my cough. So you'll need to excuse my nasally voice, and now I will read this. I really must ask you to keep Fang out of my classroom, Hagrid. Oh God. Fang is sometimes curious about cats, Professor. I'm afraid he's a bit confused by here. Fair enough. Oh, Barnaby, I thought. Oh man, he's not the end goal. I wonder who would win in a fight between Fang and Professor McGonagall, tabby cat animagus. Why is that something you're thinking about? That's not. Never mind. Wait, hold on a minute. Do you guys see that in the corner? Is Leviosa kid finally asking his crush out? No. That bobhead girl was a Gryffindor. I don't know, man. Certainly looks like your trip to the Black Lake was exciting, Srahi. It was, Penny, and it's getting us closer to finding the final cursed world. I especially liked hearing about the Merperson village. The huts nestled into the wall sounded fascinating and unusual. Now, rumor has it that Kiara is actually one of the people you can take to the final vault. I think I might actually take Kiara if she's an option. I love Kiara and I really like the idea of her coming with me. I can't believe you met the actual Mer Queen. I would be nervous addressing royalty. I'm glad your journey gave you a lead to finding the vault, because that's the Circle of Khanna's mission. But what was your favorite part of the experience, Sarai? Meeting the Queen, man. She was awesome. She looked so beautiful. I most enjoyed meeting the Mer Queen. She was quite regal and striking. I noticed she had brighter colors than the other merfolk. Excuse me. At first, I wasn't sure how to address her, Benny. But then I just decided to approach her very formally and show respect, like you should always show a queen. And now you can check meeting a real-life royal off your list of your bucket list, is what she means. Is that something people actually care about? Why has Talbot disappeared? Dude, is the game glitching already? Hold on.
I can't believe you've done this.
I was recording for only 3 minutes before the game glitched. It's good now. Is that something people actually care about? I certainly think it's fascinating. And now all that stands between us and beating Rakepick to the I said this in the last episode. In the last chapter, I don't like calling Rakepick a dark witch, or like specifically beating Rakepick. I don't feel like beating the entire cabal at this point, but let's just go with it. We are basically beating Rakepick. And now all that stands between us and beating Rakepick to the final cursed vault is finding 3 tribute items. I believe that if you can get the queen what she asked for and deliver them back quickly, she'll lead me to the vault. You sure she knows where it is? Not entirely, but right now it's our best chance. Fetch quest time. And she didn't seem like the kind of creature who would be dishonest. If Sarahi thinks we can trust the Mer Queen, I'm sure she'll help us find the vault. We're here to help Sarahi, so tell us what you need. It's a long story. I'll tell you like the sort of short version, because I only have to do this for 3 hours, thank goodness. You'll have to excuse the coughing. I'm so sorry. The Mer Queen indicated that she would like a jewel necklace. Like, let's figure this out fast because I need to feed the owls. Okay. I wonder if the mer people write songs about their treasures. Really? I admire when creatures work together. Kiara. The mer queen showed me an old broken comb she wore in her hair. The mer queen has a broken lyre and she wants a new one. So a lyre is basically a tiny harp. Since these items are for the queen, we should find ones that are quite fancy. Won't those be expensive? I quite like the idea of the mer people having a concert of their own. Their music must be amazing. If mer people enjoy music, the mer people enjoy music, which is why the Weird Sisters concert worked. Yeah. So, we need a lyre, a jeweled necklace, and a fancy comb for the mer queen's tribute. Sounds easy enough. Really? I'm not so sure. Where are we going to find a lyre that Srahi can bring easily underwater? They're usually small enough, but we'll use a shrinking charm if that's a problem. Yeah, I believe a lyre is pretty heavy. Good idea, Kiara. The fancy comb should be simplest to get, so we should focus on that last. What about the necklace? Who would have something fancy enough for a queen? In headcanon, Srahi would have something fancy enough for the queen. That's true. It's not like jewels are part of the Hogwarts uniform. I have an idea for that. Next stop, Alanza Alves. Now, if I remember correctly, Alanza gives us a necklace. But I just don't like the idea of taking her necklace, actually. Get off my screen. Okay, but may I just ask why Snape is just watching Jay eat? How unusual to see you outside the kitchens, Mr. Kim. Detention may be the sum total of your time at Hogwarts. Oh. Okay, that explains a lot. Sometimes it's night to eat my lunch with the rest of the class, though I am quite bored with sandwiches. Aren't we all? Andre, what do you got? I wonder what's important about me, food or fashion. Blimey, it's no contest. Fashion is my life. Fair enough, bye. Thanks for having lunch with me, Alanza. I always appreciate an invitation from a friend, Srahi. Look, the thing I notice is that a friend is not highlighted, so it might not be that... Why am I questioning this? I imagine you've had many invitations to socialize since organizing the Weird Sisters concert at the Lake Show. That's kind of you to say. But we both make that concert happen, Srahi. It did look like the students were having a grand time. Thanks to us, the concert was really a smashing success. It would be at this point where Alanza would comment that Srahi sings very well. So was my mission to meet the mer people, and now they may even help me find the cursed vault. But first, I need to bring their mer queen 3 tribute items. So I was hoping I could ask you one more favor. What do you need, Srahi? Would you be willing to donate a jeweled necklace for the mer queen? Well, I do have a necklace with jewels in it. That's brilliant. It's my favorite and I'm reluctant to part with it. Yes, I remembered correctly. I honestly would never ask Alanza to part with her favorite necklace. In my head, canon, Srahi just goes and gets her own necklace. But, I guess in Hogwarts Mystery, we're going to force a girl to part with her favorite necklace. I, for one, would never part with my favorite necklace. I understand, but give me a chance to make you see why it's so important. I think there's one of those Alanza... No? I thought we'd get an Alanza friendship interaction. Well, why would you... I wouldn't want to part with a favorite treasure, but there's a good reason. I just wouldn't part with it. I think there are pickles on my bacon sandwich. Who could be that? What could be more vile? A jam sandwich because nobody should eat jam because jam city. I don't know. You need to let a little light in, Srahi. Have fun at school. Alanza, don't be a small Dumbledore. I can't have fun at this point. You are sweet and I love you. Just please. Eating Rakewick and R to the cursed vault is really important. Look at the scarf I'm wearing and just like judge. There's more than one reason I say I'm hesitant to part with the necklace. Oh, is this her grandmother's necklace that I keep hearing about in the Butterbeer interactions? Oh no, I would never ask her to give me her grandmother's necklace. That is just cruel. Dude, this is so mean. Why would Jam City do this? I would never ask her to part with the grandmother's necklace. That is just horrible. You do make a good argument, Sarahi, and I agree that beating Rekpek and the art of the cursed world is important. But I'm still worried that you're so focused on beating Rekpek that you're not having enough fun at school. Dude, she literally murdered my best friend in front of my eyes. How can I have fun at school? Say that! You have to say that. So I'll give you the necklace on one condition. Name it. You have to tell me one totally fun and frivolous thing you've always wanted to do, but never accomplished. Oh my god, these options are both cute. I would love to dance. Now, I just thought about it from a headcanon standard. From my headcanon standard, Sarahi would have no answer to give, and this is where she would realize that Alanza's right. She really does have no fun left in her. And that is when she would leave and say like, no, I don't want your necklace, that's alright, you don't have to part with your favorite treasure. I'll go get one myself. But well, for the game though, if I have to choose one. I've always wanted to dance in the litter of Krupp Pups. That's adorable.
Oh.
A Krupp Pup party sounds fantastically fun. But perhaps the closest you'll get to dancing with an animal inside Hogwarts is Mrs. Norris. I'm not sure I'd want that, Alanza. I can't imagine it would go over well with Filch. See, I can have a fun and frivolous side as well as chase cursed words. That is a lie, the actual line with me. Alanza's right. I don't even have a fun and frivolous side left. Alright, Sahi, you answered my question and I see you indeed still have a fun side. I do not. So I'll get you the necklace for the Mer-Queen. Thanks, Alanza. That's two I owe you this month. But wait, you said you needed 3 tribute items. What's next on the list? A liar, and for that I'm going to recruit the sneakiest bloke I know at Hogwarts, J. Kim, who ate his lunch and left the Great Hall like 10 minutes ago. God damn it. Here we are, back to the kitchens. I actually missed this place. Hello. Oh my god, why are you so angry? Cheers, Jay. I'm glad I was able to catch you here. Where else would student J. Kim be? J. Kim always puts food to serve for dinner. What? Alright, Pits, don't get angry. Or should I say more angry than usual? Pits, may I speak with Jay alone for just a few minutes? Why should Pits give student J. Kim a break for student Sarahi Silvers? Appeal to Pits the taskmaster? I have no idea what that means. Because Jay will work even harder after a break. I immediately regret my decision and I will be soft resetting. I actually decided that the soft reset was worth nothing because I went with the same option. I remember the data mine and I remember that I want to get something out of it. Because Jay will work even harder after a break. What is that? Which is what a taskmaster like you would want, right, Pits? That would be good for Pits. Hey, don't I get a say in this? I'll be just a minute and then I promise Jay will get right back to work. Pits will agree, but after that, Pits doesn't want any more excuses. Just dinner for house elves to serve. I'm so sorry, Jay. That was some smooth talking, Sarahi. Now who's the sneaky one? I hope I didn't cause you any more trouble by showing up here, Jay. Well, I'm not crazy about you promising that I'll work harder, but I get that you were just trying to get rid of Pits. And my middle name is Trouble. Actually, it's Bo. But it might as well be Trouble since I'm already finding it. Ladies and gentlemen, his full name is J. Bo Kim. And that is why I realized that it was no point to the soft reset. I did soft reset and now I'll have more time editing. But still. So don't worry about it. So, but what did you need, Sarahi? I met the Mer-Queen in the Black Lake and I think she's going to lead me to the cursed world. But first, I need to bring her 3 tribute items. I've got a necklace so far. But I'm not sure where to find the next item she wants, which is a liar. You know, you nearly need to stop doing the kiss I'll die face, it's getting concerning. So you came to me to figure out how to acquire the most challenging prize. I appreciate that, Sarahi. A liar could be hard to come by. I thought we could talk about how I might get one since you're so resourceful. Why not? Pits is busy bothering the house elves, so let's do it. I wonder if I could find a liar in a shop. To be honest, you should have been able to find it in Maestro's music shop, but that's still locked till year 7 for some reason. Procuring items, potions, and other contraband is my specialty. We know this, Jay. That's why we've come to you. I wonder if any one of our teachers might have a liar in their quarters. Why would they have one? The mob people really seem to appreciate music, but the queen's lyre is broken. I bet the queen plays the best music. I bet music is required to open the world. The lyre is large enough that someone would notice if it were missing. So you can't steal it. I definitely can see why you came to me with this problem. The house elves are always working. That's the plight of the house elf. Oh, that's the house elf talking, okay. I bet I'll have to trade something good for this lyre. So you can't steal it, no? Jay Kim should stay out of trouble so Jay Kim could stay out of the kitchens. Oh, he has a good point. I have an idea of where to get a lyre, but it won't be easy. What we do ever is. Finding the Mer Queen a lyre is an interesting challenge, Sarahi. I agree that it won't be easy, Jay, but you'll get us one. In part because you're a master trader, but also because I know you believe in the Circle of Kanna's mission and want to avenge Rohan. You're right, of course, so I'm all in. Sarahi, I'll get you that lyre. Thank you, Jay. What else have I got to do anyway? Beating Rakepik to a cursed world is better than getting bossed around by pits. Lol, that's a good point. And now all that's left is to gather a fine comb. It should be simple enough. And once I do, I can return to the Black Lake and fight the final cursed world. Let's go. Get that comb. Why are we going to the prefect's bathroom to find a comb? That makes no sense. It still makes no sense to me, like, why we're searching for a comb in the prefect's bathroom. But I guess I will not question much. Why would there be a comb in the prefect's bathroom anyway? And why would we find a comb in the prefect's bathroom? That makes no sense. Unless someone left it around. Thanks for helping me search the prefect's bathroom, Charlie. Don't mention it, Sarahi. This is important Circle of Kanna business. Though it seems completely mad that somehow all the combs in Hogwarts have just up and disappeared. There wasn't a single one to be found in my house. It's not house, it's your dorm. You stupid idiot. I know, I don't mean my MC, I mean the person who wrote this line. All the other Circle of Kanna members reported the same thing in their houses. Oh, I take that back immediately. I'm so sorry to have read that line. I just understood. They mean the house, like Hufflepuff, House Gryffindor, House Ravenclaw. I'm an idiot. I take that back immediately. I apologize. All I know is that the timing of the combs vanishing couldn't be worse. The Mer Queen asked me to find a fine comb, a necklace and a lyre and bring them back to her. And if I can, she might lead me to the final cursed world. I heard Jay is working on the lyre and Alanza agreed to give you a necklace. And I'm grateful to them both, but without a comb, I won't be fulfilling the Mer Queen's request. Which means that R might reach the cursed world before us, and that can only be bad for everyone at school. So there must be someone who knows where all the combs went. Like literally where all the combs went. My hair is a mess. Oh, there is! Hi, Duncan. Caramel's gonna be happy about your appearance. Duncan Ash, there you are. It's been a while, Sarahi. Happy to see me? I am! Of course I'm happy to see you, Duncan. Despite the bad blood between you and my brother before you died, I know you were a good friend, Fizz. Oh. I won't say that. Dude, stop fighting it, really. People rarely come here looking for me unless they need something. Which once again, you obviously do. No, I don't really need anything. That being said, I do visit you often. Yeah. Wait, Duncan, were you implying that you know where the combs have disappeared to where you first appeared? Maybe I am, maybe I'm not. Oh my god, why am I whispering? Duncan, if you know, you have to tell us, please. Let me get into the vault. I can explain why. And when you hear what's going on, I know you'll want to help. Fair, we'll see about that. Can this guy stop being a sundar? I don't know what that means. What good is being a ghost if you don't take advantage of it? Well, okay. Are you saying you got rid of all the combs, Duncan? Literally look at my hair, it's a mess. I'm in a foul mood about being dead. It's a permanent state of disappointment. He's not wrong. Doesn't make me feel good that you came here looking for Combs and not me. We're trying to beat out of the final cursed world. Do you want to see them defeated or not? Even in death, R is still thorn in my side, but the prick stings less than a ghost. Oh, prick! Maybe I should visit you more often, Duncan. I do visit you more often! He said prick. He literally was a trick, didn't he? R is the one that did wrong by you and Jacob, so you should help us. I don't understand why he's still mad at Jacob. I really don't. I heard all about your little plan, Sarahi. So you literally took all the combs. Why would you do that? Why did you do any of that? Death is a constant state of disappointment, he says. And I've never related to anything more in my life. So you see, Duncan, you simply have to tell us where the combs are. Literally, we just need one at this point. If you still hate R, this is a great way to get back at them for what they did to you. I certainly do hate R, but I'm no fan of Jacob. And so by association, I don't like you much either, Sarahi. Jam City really loves screwing up characters, don't they? You would think that after all this time he'd be Uncle Duncan. So I guess you'll just have to figure out the mystery of who took the combs by yourself. Just like I spend most of my time here as a ghost by myself. See you both later, or probably not. Duncan, wait! I thought we were past all this. Duncan! Caruin, they literally keep ruining Duncan! You know what, I'm just gonna stick to your canon from now on. Well, that didn't go very well. No, it didn't, but the comb is the final item we need for the Merqueen, and I'm not giving up. The prefect's bathroom would be the hardest place for whoever took the combs to get into. So there must be some clue around here. Tulip! Rock!
Go!
What the? Is that a toad? Dennis! He reminds you of the frog spawn incident, where I permanently switched to showers. Dennis is the name of the YouTuber who won in the Roblox battles today. I find that ironic and coincidental. That's Tulip's pet. She never goes anywhere without him. And come to think of it, she loves pranks too. Tulip must be behind the missing combs. Why would she do that? Croc, where are you? What are you going to do, Sarahi? I'm going to take Dennis back to Tulip. And when I do, I bet I'll find the combs I need for the Merqueen. Dennis wins again. I'm not disappointed, I'm just saying. Meet me and the Weasley twins in the court, in the corridor, she said. Tulip, give me my comb back. My hair's a mess. Tulip, I swear to God, where are the combs? Tulip? Tulip! Oh, there they are. Give me my combs back. Croak! Huh. Dennis, I was wondering where you'd hopped off to. The ironic thing is that my toad Naveen looks exactly like this, down to the dung bomb skin. I like the dung bomb skin. Hi Tulip, Fred, George, Nora. Hello Sarahi. Yeah, Nora would be here in my canon. You guys know I started updating Broken Protector again. The bonus chapters will take me longer to write. Charlie and I found Dennis in the prefect's bathroom. I thought it odd that he was lost there since none of you are prefects and won't have any reason to be in there. Guess it's a mystery. I'm not so sure. I think Dennis being in the bathroom might have something to do with why our combs are missing. The three of you wouldn't have any idea why that might be the case, would you? Sarahi, I'm offended. George, my boy, I literally see the cauldron full of combs behind you. White, are you calling us thieves? Definitely. Definitely, because there's a cauldron full of combs right there. Nice work, Weasleys. You were supposed to hide it. I thought we covered it fast enough. But we're not technically stealing, Sarahi.
Yeah.
It's not really stealing because we plan to return all the combs to their owners. For an epic prank on all of Hogwarts, but let us explain. How are you guys still thinking about these pranks, man? These days, we could all use a laugh at Hogwarts, to be fair. The prank we're executing could be our best yet. People obsess about their hair. For good reason. I have no hair. I mean, I have very less hair, but I have a problem. We're going to charm the combs in this cauldron and wreck people's hair. Oh my god, why would you do that? That's cruel. Once we finish, these combs will turn their owner into a hideous color. Okay, I guess changing color isn't that bad. I had a feeling this might have something to do with pranking when I found Dennis. I'm wondering if your toad would give us what, Tulip? No, that's not possible. Be prepared for your face to hurt from the last you'll induce with this prank. I will not be touching any of your combs for a long time now. You know, it just occurred to me that I'm a prefect. Shouldn't I be stopping this prank? So as you can see, Sarahi, we're quite excited to turn everyone in Hogwarts' hair into a hideous color. By the time we're done, even Snape's hair will look as ugly as flubberworm mucus. Enchanted combs do sound funny, and I know you all love a good prank. I let it slide. I may be a prefect. But I need to ask for one of those combs back. The plan is for everyone to have bad hair, Sarahi. George is right, the prank only reaches its truly epic potential if the whole school looks ugly. I have a really good reason for needing it. The Mer Queen of the Black Lake is going to lead me to the cursed vault. But only if I bring her back three gifts she requested. And one of them is a fancy comb. Blimey, Sarahi, you had to go and give us a good reason, didn't you? Yes, now give me a comb. I think we have to help Sarahi out after all. I suppose beating Rake Pick to the cursed vault is nearly as important as this epic prank. I love these kids. Alright, Sarahi, I guess we can spare one comb for good cause. Thanks, you won't regret it. I already do, but go ahead, prick the prettiest one you can find from the cauldron. It's her queen after all. Ooh, that is pretty! The Mer Queen is sure to like this one. Oh, that is pretty, man. Brilliant, now let us get back to work. I'm sorry I sound so bad, the throat. Good luck with the prank! Hope you don't get caught. That's usually the best part of the fun. Look! You're right, Dennis. Now that I have this comb, it's almost time to return to the Mer Queen. With a little help from my friends, I'm closer than ever to beating out of the final cursed world.
You make the hardest task look easy.
Yes! We're almost there, guys. We're almost there. That was it for this chapter. It will still be a few chapters before we are able to like get into the vault. It will take Jay a few chapters to actually be able to acquire the lyre. I have I have read a few data mines. The data mines are only available up to chapter 40. Which means I don't know anything after that, and even the chapter 40 data mine is not complete. Which means that the next few chapters, they're going to have something big happen. The last time Jam City hit the data mines, it was to hide Rowan's death. They are hiding the data mines again. But rumors have already started spreading. Kiara is one of the potential options. Kiara and Talbot actually are potential options to take with you to the cursed world along with Marula and Ben. Another rumor that has been flying that I've mentioned already that's important to me is that the fact that the cursed vault does not bode well for Rakepig. In fact, one more thing. I was hoping that by the time we get to the end of year 6, I would have reached my goal of 5,000 subscribers and I'd begin using a face cam. As of now, I still don't have proper equipment. It's taking me a long time to decide on the equipment because I need to make sure that the camera and microphone I get are good quality and they work for me for years. I don't want to accidentally buy something expensive and then have not use it. So I'll give you guys a kind of a bargain. 45 is one of my favorite numbers. I originally thought that 5,000 subscribers would be the goal before I start using a face cam, but I changed my mind. 4,500 subscribers and I begin using a face cam. I thought I'm really hoping we can get I needed to pause for a second. Now I'm really hoping we are able to get to 4,500 subscribers before the chapter in which we enter the vault, because I really, really want to use face cam when the end of year 6 comes, because that chapter is going to be amazing and it's going to be action packed and, well, it's going to have the word. So I want to have my reaction recorded, because I don't know anything about it. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. Again, I apologize, I sound so bad and nasally. My throat is still not good. In fact, it's really hard for me to keep talking. I would really like for you all to like this video and subscribe to this channel. According to YouTube, most of you don't subscribe and still enjoy my content. So if you're enjoying my content, please subscribe. And don't forget to comment. And I will make sure I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye and have a nice day.